They are supposed to ease congestion on our roads, but doctors say e-bikes are causing queues in our emergency departments. A spike in accidents now has trauma surgeons calling for the e-bike rental industry to be regulated.
On street corners, footpaths, bike lanes and even in traffic, e-bikes are becoming increasingly popular, but they can be dangerous. Renting an e-bike for a food delivery job to fund his working holiday nearly cost Tom his life.
I lost control about the front wheel and then I flipped over my handlebar and pushed my handlebar inside of my belly and landed on my head.
Travelling at 30 kilometres an hour in a bike lane when he lost control, the 21-year-old suffered a ruptured spleen, internal bleeding and broken ribs. If he wasn't wearing a helmet, it could have been worse.
I think if I wouldn't have wear a helmet, I would have hurt my head.
What would you say to people who are getting on these bikes without their helmets?
You're stupid, wear a helmet, really. It saved my life in the end.
In the last 2 years, over 500 e-bike riders have ended up in the emergency department, 16% of those at St Vincent's Hospital.
We're having an increase in the number of accidents that are occurring with e-bikes. You can die from a simple head injury that is bad to having abdominal organs removed, and that takes months to recover.
Concerningly, the majority of patients are young males. Two-thirds of those weren't wearing a helmet and a third had been drinking. Over 50% of crashes happen at night after 8 p.m. A trend trauma surgeons say needs to be stopped, calling on e-bike companies, council and government to crack down.
E-bikes shouldn't be the first option for people that walk out of a pub.
Potentially limiting the use of these bikes in the late hours of the night when the majority of riders potentially would be under the influence of alcohol, and it's quite difficult to see riders at night.
Sophie Upcroft, Nine News.